for every child, their father is a superhero. And in my case, I always thought of him as somebody who was a savior. Not just a job for him, it was a calling of duty. It took a long time for me to even accept that he is no more. And I was in Boston at that time, and my husband got a call from the government of India that they have sponsored our tickets to Bombay, and I felt that even after he has passed away, he is still taking care of us. So I could not believe that such a calamity would ever happen, and he was only 54. And in the past few years, I mean, I just wanted to see him as a grandfather playing with my two daughters, and I feel that that is not something that will ever happen. But I want my daughters to know him, so through the medium of this book, I mean, now they are 5 and 8, but when they grow up, when they read the book, they would know their grandfather. Growing up, I always felt jealous of the people he spent time with, because he placed his uniform, his job. I mean, it was not just a job for him, it was a calling of duty. He tried to approach things from the grassroots level, and that always took more time. I mean, I can give you a small example. I remember when we were posted in Chandrapur, I was 10 years old at that time, and he told me this, that I had gone and visited interior of the villages trying to talk to the people to understand, because the Naxalite problem was huge in Chandrapur. He was the superintendent of police. And he said, I spoke to the children and I asked them, what would you like to be when you grow up? So many children said Shekhar Anna, who was the Naxalite leader. And my dad said that they don't even have good role models. They perceive that the policemen are enemies and the Naxalite leader is closer to them. And how do I change this situation? I mean, not just by firing bullets and killing terrorists, but he wanted to approach things from a grassroots level. He engaged interpreters, translators, and he went to the villages with his team of policemen, and he spoke to the children, he spoke to the villagers, and he told them that the police are on their side. You can change things through law and order rather than, you know, just by violence. So he established a dialogue. So he was so thorough that, you know, all these things need a lot of time and patience. So as a child, I felt that, you know, I cannot get that much time with my dad. But then I realized that he is somebody who is more focused on social work, on changing the country, changing society. He devoted his entire life to that cause. So I understood that as I started growing up. I just feel that every country should respect their martyr, somebody who has laid down his life for the country. That is the supreme sacrifice anyone can do for the nation, and they should always be respected. He was a strict disciplinarian, but at the same time, he always gave us enough freedom to make our own decisions. He would never set down the law at home that, you know, this has to be done. He would give us pros and cons, you know, of doing things in a certain way. And he hoped that by telling us about the pros and cons, we would be able to choose the correct angle on our own. So I could see that he wanted to empower us to make our own decisions rather than forcing something. So he said, you know, you may make mistakes down the road, but you will learn. He was always very methodical and neat and organized in everything. He always had a plan for everything, like even smallest things. If you opened his cupboard, everything was neatly arranged, and we almost joked that he had a photographic snapshot of how things are, because if me or my siblings managed to touch his cupboard and move a few things around and try to keep it back in the same place, he would say that, you know, somebody has changed things. He had a diary. Every day he would jot down what he had, you know, his to-do list. So he was always so organized. I now when I look back, I feel that, you know, as a police officer, he may have had to deal with so many stresses and strains, but at home he was always upbeat. I always remember him very fresh and always enthusiastic. I never saw him. He had so much of energy, it was infectious.